When we teach young children about operations, it's helpful to use concrete objects to model what's happening when we add or subtract, so that kids can see what's really going on, that students know what action is associated with each of those mathematical operations. In this lesson, we're going to use base 10 blocks, and I have units, and I have rods, and then I have a place value chart, in order to solve a lesson with addition and regrouping. For the problem, we're thinking about Erica, who plays basketball. She scored 18 points in the first half of the game, and then 5 points in the second half of the game. How many points did she score altogether? We use addition, and we'll need to regroup in order to solve this problem. I'm assuming for the model lesson here that students already know how to take 10 units and exchange them for one tens rod. They have an understanding of that equivalence, and we're now going to extend that understanding into addition. To solve the problem, I'm going to start by modeling. Erica scored 18 points in the first half, so I have 110 and 8 ones to represent that score. And then she scored an additional 5 points in the second half of the game, so I add to my mat, or I join, 5 more units to represent the 5 points in that second half of the game. In order to add, I know I've got to combine these, and it looks like I've got a lot more than 10. So I'm going to line them up on my one side. And I see that I can exchange those 10 units for a second rod. And when I do that, I know that the answer to my problem is that she scored 23 points altogether. There are a number of things we need to talk to students about when they solve a problem like this. And I'm going to move to a virtual base 10 block representation, like you might use on an interactive whiteboard, in order to talk about some of those ideas. I'll start the problem the same way, where I have 18 represented as her score in the first half, and I have 5 represented as her score in the second half. If I don't want children to line up their pieces, I can have them group or circle 10 that they can exchange for a 10. There are going to be times, though, as students develop, that we want them to work without base 10 blocks at all. And in this case, I'll keep my place value mat, but I'm going to draw a representation. I'll use a line segment and 8 dots to represent the 18 points she scored in the first half. And then I'll add 5 more dots to represent the 5 points that she scored in the second half. I can create my group of 10 by circling it, draw a second line segment and my 10 side to represent that that is 110, and by seeing what's outside the circle, 3 ones and another 20 for my 2 tens, now I have 23. As students get comfortable with these representations, I want to move even one step further and write the problem in a traditional way, where I would record 18 plus 5, and I know 5 plus 8 is 13, and represent regrouping in a more traditional format. This makes sense to students at this stage when it's the end of the activity, the end of their learning progression, because they know that what they're writing down is what they built when they made their trade. They've seen 5 plus 8 equals 13, and how that becomes 110 and 3 ones. And now I'm just teaching them a more formal mathematical way of representing it.